you're gonna make a movie to the United States.
Yeah, you want in?
Yeah, sure. Hey, folks.
Hello, everyone. Curtis White here from the Cannondale CyclocrossWorld.com team, and today we are racing the World Cup in Dendermonde. The conditions were absolutely epic today, with temperatures not much above freezing and Storm Bella rolling through with high winds and consistent rain. And because the course was deteriorating at such a rate, we were directed onto the course just after the hole shot. And you'll notice very quickly that the layout is mostly flat, with a couple mounds, lots of heavy mud farm fields, and standing water. And this is really just old school cyclocross in this diesel effort of mashing and big gear. Now, something to note as we're going through the first series of turns here, there's really nothing complicated here, but the promoters had several difficult decisions in the months and hours leading into this race. This race was relocated to this venue after the previous venue and municipality canceled the event due to COVID, and this was the backup venue that the race settled on. And in the hours leading into this race, they were at risk of canceling due to the intensity of the storm and the high winds, but they decided to carry on and make the necessary changes to make it happen. In the end, there are some critics of this course and venue, but as a racer, I can't have any of that in my head. It's a distraction, and all I'm focusing on is how do I use the tools that I have to the best of my ability for the job in front of me. And right now, the job is a total diesel effort. You'll see that we came off that first part of the course onto this hard-packed felt here, and we're coming up this hill for the first time. This is the furthest that I made up the hill the entire course, just as the course was deteriorating at such a rate that this all became a run-up. I wasn't remounting here at the top like I am in pre-ride. Here we'll see Michael Vandeham, Canadian here, give me a little tip on this rut. But this all became a run-up, and this turned into an old-school, some people called it Swiss-style cyclocross, so you're running uphill, downhill, and on the flats. But coming onto this felt bridge, a couple ruts off that bridge, and we're coming by pit one. And while it was a really heavy, heavy track, there wasn't a lot of heavy mud setting on the bikes or creating a risk of ripping the derailleur off or throwing off the chain. There really wasn't any of that, and we were a bit fortunate with that. But it was good just to keep the gears and the chain and the brakes all clean and just have regular maintenance done to the bike. It was more preventative bike changes. But we come to these series of turns. There were some really deep ruts that started to form, and it's really difficult just to see what it was like in the race versus the pre-ride, but this was all under these really deep puddles, and it was very difficult to gauge just how deep these ruts were, and the ruts were getting bigger and bigger and wider and deeper every single lap. So this part of the course was rideable in the race, but we were dismounting around this point, and we were starting to come up this second hill of the course. I could see here, staying left onto that green patch. Green means traction, green means go, and riding across the hill and then trying to descend it here. But in the between the women's and the men's race, the course got so torn up that we were running up that side of the hill and back down and remounting on this really goopy hard-packed underlayer there. But we're on a little side road now. I tried the line here on the right. On the first lap, I tried the line all the way to the left, but there was a nice groove coming down right the middle that seemed to be the most hard-packed, and that's where everyone was riding. But in the end, it was good to learn from what other riders were doing with certain lines, but you couldn't focus too much engaging your effort on what other people were doing all the time. It was you had to race your own race. It was you versus the course before it's you versus any of your competitors. And if you lose that race against the course, you've already lost against your competitors. So we're off that pavement section, a couple turns here, and it's wide open through this grassy field. A couple turns bending to the right, left, right, left. We would have gone under the flyover here, but again, with the storm being so intense and there's high winds all day, the promoters had to alter the course, take out that flyover there, no stairs over the flyover, and they had to reverse some of the course and take out a couple of parts. But in the race, all of this got heavy, and we were really running this entire section through these turns. Running this, it got really bogged out. A couple powerhouses were able to ride through it the first couple laps, but again, it was deteriorating so much. Now, for today, the tires that I chose were Challenge Limas's at 17-18 PSI. Really low pressure, hitting the rims. And in my course inspection, I was really making sure I was able to identify certain trouble points, if there's any rocks or roots under the surface. But after only one pre-riding lap, it became very clear that there wasn't a lot of threats to equipment under the surface here. It's a really soft, boggy farm field here. You can see up the third mound of the day. Really difficult to ride, even when the grass was more fresh now. But this became another heavier part of the course. It's a real diesel effort for the last couple minutes, on the bike, off the bike, up this run up, down that drop. Try to carry your momentum as far as you can. But before we got to this turn, again in the race, it got so torn up that we were running this. We were off the bike. But in the pre-ride, we were able to muscle the bike through this. And typically for my pre-ride laps, I like to do 3 laps in total. The first one is more of an inspection. The second lap is more piecing the sections together, starting to dial in the tire pressure. And the third lap, I start to test sections in at race pace and really test the equipment in lines and maybe try a couple alternate lines. But I threw all that out the window today because it's such an unusual heavy course. We don't get a lot of courses like this in cyclocross. This is really that old school tractor pull that you don't have a lot of anymore. And it required a lot of composure, finesse, and really staying topped off on the energy and not going too much into the red. So I cut the pre-ride short. I only did a lap and a half, which looking back was a very good move, I thought, just because the course was changing so much from the experience that I had. I knew it was going to keep changing. The ruts were going to keep changing. It was important just to identify if there are any trouble points with the tire pressure and then go out, trust my skills, and go from there. So we have a couple series of turns here. We're going to be approaching part of the course that the promoters had to eventually take out for the men's race. Here, our race eventually went to the right there, but we're going through this bog. It's really, really heavy, and we're going up this mound. On the backside, we saw an unfortunate clip of Katie Compton, her foot and bike getting stuck in the mud here. It just got so boggy and thick. But again, there are a lot of critics of this course, and right, wrong, or otherwise, in that moment, you have a job in front of you, and I was just... I had to push a lot of that out of the head. I couldn't have an opinion of this course of this is terrible, I don't like this course, because the moment you have those negative thoughts, you've already lost the battle against the course. So trying to get your momentum back out of here. Again, this part of the course wasn't in for the men's race, it was for the women's, but the promoters decided to take it out between races. Now we're coming into another couple series of turns here, bending to the right, to the left, to the right, to the left. There's a lot of snaking in and out of these turns, and the course would have had a much different feel if this was completely dry, hard packed, or if it was on frozen ground. The course would have been much faster, there would have been more group racing, but just due to the conditions, it was you versus the course, and that was the biggest battle you had to overcome. And through these turns, ruts were getting really deep. The lines I'm taking right now, I'm trying to go the most direct route, cutting the apex through a lot of these turns, but that's where a lot of the ruts were later in the race. So trying to find alternate lines, trusting I know how to handle my bike and find those alternate lines, going around outside of these corners, seeing if there's any fresh ruts or fresh grass I can find grip on. Now we're coming up over this little bridge here, this hard packed, which is a nice little reprieve, able to spin the gear up, get a little momentum, lift the front wheel up. We had a couple of ruts. You didn't want that front wheel sinking in again. Up on this hard packed again, through this puddle. Again, I was lifting the front wheel up, kind of doing a little wheelie off that ledge just to make sure I'm not nose wheeling it into that puddle because it was really deep and thick. And we're going to be approaching pit two here. And I found that there was an advantage coming in every single lap to pit. While the bikes weren't getting really heavily caked with mud, it was good to get a clean machine every single time, but there were a couple nice ruts and puddles that I was able to ride through the pit. We had box 14 in the World Cups were appointed boxes, so we had a later box in the pit. I was able to get a clean bike before this corner. In this straightaway here, we're within the last couple hundred meters of this course, but this got really rutted out, and you had this really thin strip of hard packed underneath this mud cover, but there were ruts sending you in all different directions, and when the fatigue was setting in laps 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, you were just letting the bike go where it wanted to, and unfortunately it caught a wrong rut and it would send you in the wrong direction. But through this little checkpoint, again, would have had very different feel if the course was faster, up over the barriers, as if we didn't have enough running today. But no one was bunny hopping. A lot of people were shouldering over the barriers, running for the 30, 40 meters before the barriers, and then after the barriers. Some people were remounting on this pavement strip here to that last puddle. And we're really a couple hundred meters from the finish. And it's not an explosive course at all. It's really that diesel effort. And you had to continue to operate at that 90% level, because if you went into the red, it was very easy to blow up. So we're approaching this last corner here, bending to the right, maybe 150 meters from the finish. And that's the course. It's a super heavy track that was deteriorating by the minute and required a lot of real diesel power and effort on and off the bike, and required a really all-around stable athlete. So I hope you enjoyed this video. Thank you for watching. Please subscribe for more videos through the course of the cyclocross season and share with your friends. You can visit curtisjwhite.com/intherid for more content. Take care, stay healthy, keep riding, and we'll catch you next in Bredene.